In this video, I'm going to share with you how to paint a flamingo with a playful abstract background. Let's learn art, be creative, and relax while we paint. Make sure you hit that subscribe button so you can enjoy more videos. Hey, it's Ashley Krieger here. Welcome to Createful Art. Today we are traveling to the Caribbean, specifically the Bahamas, to get inspired. And you know what? You don't have to be there. You can travel there through art. The national bird and animal of the Bahamas is the flamingo. The Caribbean flamingo almost went extinct, which would be really sad because it's a beautiful bird. But with conservation efforts, they were able to bring it back. I'm happy that we can see them again in the Bahamas, and this inspired me to share this painting with you today. If we want to continue enjoying the beautiful things in this world, we have to take care of it. I'm excited you're here to relax with me and paint this flamingo, so let's begin. All you need are a few basic supplies to begin. I will list them right over here on the left and in the description with links to where you can find them. I use a color chart to mix and match my colors. There's a lesson for you on how to make your own color chart. I'll have a link to it for you in the description. All you're going to need for this tutorial is a dark pink or a coral color, a light pink, your black and white, and whatever colors you want to paint in your background. There is an art lesson plan that goes along with this tutorial. In it, it'll include color mixing help, reference photos, the traceable, the full tutorial, and step-by-step instructions. This is for those who need additional help and want to learn how to become better artists. I'll provide links to the lesson plan in the description of this video. Once your colors are all mixed, then you just need a few simple supplies like your surface to paint on and your brushes, and you can begin. The first step is to sketch your flamingo with a blue watercolor pencil, unless you want to paint your background first and then sketch over it. Use the traceable in your handout to help you. Next, we're going to paint the abstract background. You can get creative in this step and create whatever background you want, or you can follow along. I'm using my half-inch brush to make vertical lines in the colors that I want. I'm going to make sure that I block in my flamingo, which means that I'm not going to go over my flamingo lines. Because I used watercolor pencils or ink tense pencils, if I touch the blue color, it will start spreading into my paint. I'm not going to worry about it, I'm just going to use it to my advantage when I want to have some light blue. I'm going to use the colors on my palette that are light, or I'm going to mix those colors with white. I'm not going to tell you which colors to use exactly when because I want you to be creative with this background. You could do vertical lines, you could do splatters, you could do any type of abstract background, and you can choose your colors. You could do dark colors so that your flamingo will pop out as the light object, or you can do light colors like I'm doing, and your flamingo will pop out as the darker object. Now we're going to paint the flamingo with the coral color and your round brush. This first layer of coral covers the entire flamingo except for the beak and the eye. Your brush strokes should go in the direction of the feathers, and you want to have short brush strokes for the short feathers in the direction that they go, and long brush strokes for the long feathers in the directions that they should go. There are no feathers on the legs, so you just fill those in and paint those with a line. The blue watercolor pencil will drag over with your paint and create a gray tone, which we'll use for the shadow areas. So don't worry about it mixing with your paint or bleeding into your paint at all. To get this first layer down, it's all about when and where to drag the color, so use the reference photo to help you. Once you have your first layer down, then you're ready for the next step. So you'll want to fill in the beak with light pink paint using your round or your detail brush. Take your time while you're painting to make sure that the color blends in and becomes a solid color for the first layer of your beak. Paint the end of the beak with black, and the shape is filled in at the bottom and comes to a point at the top. If you have a lot of paint on your brush, go ahead and wipe it off on your paper towel. If not, just put the very tip of your brush in the black, because we're going to use the tip as a liner to create this line from the top of the point of the beak that is black to that point that is white next to the eye. Wipe off your brush and then add white or the light pink to the eye. You're just creating a small dot with the end of your brush. You may have to go in a circle motion to get it a little bit bigger if it's too small. So I let that dry, and I'm going to wipe off my brush and add some light pink to it. And now I'm going to add an additional layer over my beak. Now I don't want to cover the black line, and I don't want to go over all of the gray that's underneath it or that blue color. I want to leave an edge around it so it looks like shadow. So just paint in between the lines. If your eye is also dry, you can add the black dot in the center of the eye. If not, you're gonna want to wait until it is, like I'm going to do. Now we're gonna paint an additional layer of the light pink feathers, and this gives us another layer over our bird. So you wanna put light pink on your round brush, and again, we're going in the direction of the feathers. You can pause the video whenever you need to, and you can use the reference photo to help you know where to place the light pink. And now I'm going to fix the circle around my eye and then add the dot of black in the center because it is now dry. The light color is now dry. Back to my light pink. Now I'm going to add the feathers, a layer of the light pink feathers onto the back here. Again, going in the direction, I don't want to cover all of the coral paint and I don't want to cover all the shadow. I'm just going to add just a few feathers over the top. What I want to do is make sure that the wings are separated from the body. So just make sure that you use your reference photo to help you if you need it. You can decide how many of the light feathers that you want, and then you put coral on your brush. And now we're going to get in some medium tones and add another layer. So right next to the light pink, I'm going to add a layer of the coral, and I'll leave the dark next to the edges. Same thing with the brush strokes, they go in the direction of the feathers. You don't really want to do any blending here. So you're just putting the colors next to each other, or you're putting a color on top of the other color. The last step is the final details, and that always has to do with your personal preferences. If you find that you've covered too much of the shadow area, you can just put it back in with your blue. I'm gonna add a little bit more color to my flamingo's legs. I'm gonna add some of the light pink just right along the front edges of the legs so it looks like the light is shining on them. You don't have to do this, but if you like the look, then go ahead and follow right along. And then I'm gonna add the coral, the darker pink, as well to the legs. So I'm basically doing the same thing I did with the flamingo feathers. I'm just adding in some more layers of color so I get some medium tone and I cover a little bit of the blue a little more. The more details that we add, the more realistic it's going to look. So it's up to you how far you want to go with realism. The next thing I'm going to do is work on my background. I just think it needs a little bit to feel like it's finished. You can follow along if that's what you're doing, or you can just finish up right now if you want. And you're done with your painting whenever you're happy with it. So if you enjoyed this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up and make sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on any of my tutorials and lessons. I'm gonna finish up real soon here, so I just wanna give you the art tip for the day. I hope you learned from this lesson that there is no one right way to make art. You may have a preference of making more abstract art like we did in this background where there's less rules, it's more playful, or you may like to work more precise or more realistic. There are a lot of styles that include both like we did today in this painting, and there are a lot of styles that are in between. And maybe that's how you like to create. In the lesson plan, we talk about different art styles and why they are important to know about. So if you want to get weekly art lessons, go ahead and sign up to become a Createful Art member, or you can look in the description to a link to this specific lesson. Let me know what you learned from watching today, and if you have any questions, you can always reach me in the comments. Thank you for relaxing and getting creative with me today. I can't wait to share next week's painting with you, and I'll see you in my next video.